I think it's time.
All right. Do we have to do something here, or does it... It does it by itself.
December 3rd, 2001. Dean Kamen becomes a household name as the inventor of the Segway.
This is the world's first self-balancing human transporter.
Self-balancing human transporting. You stand there, it goes.
But ask Kamen today about the Segway, and his opinion might surprise you.
I would argue that, though I'm still to this day known as the Segway guy, compared to all the stuff I've done, I would say the Segway is a footnote and probably the least significant project we ever did.
As a kid, Kamen says he was too busy tinkering to go to class or even finish college. He dropped out and around that same time came up with his first invention in his parents' basement. An automatic syringe that would change the standard of care for people living with diabetes.
It created, you know, a way to give particularly kids with diabetes a nice continuous amount of insulin throughout the day, much more natural than a shot or two.
In the 1970s, Kamen moved from Long Island to New Hampshire, sold the auto syringe company, and started Decca Research. In the early 90s, he created the first portable dialysis machine that would change the game.
Hi, honey.
For people like my mom, living with chronic kidney disease.
I had my first transplant in 1979.
Bedford native Vanessa Underwood got her first kidney from her mother. 10 years later, a second gift from her sister. And then, in 2011...
We're recording. What day is it?
Day one.
How do you feel, honey?
My mom underwent a third transplant, thanks to a donation from her best friend. All these years, she's admired Dean Kamen for creating the portable dialysis machine, allowing patients to be dialyzed in the privacy and comfort of their home instead of a clinic. And when my mom learned what Kamen is working on now...
I have goosebumps.
She was blown away.
When this story came along, it kind of gave me hope that, God forbid I need another transplant, there's hope that I don't need to take another organ from anybody, that I might be able to use my own.
What if you could go to a place and instead of buying this kind of thing, which has a few billion transistors in it, you could get a little organ that has a few billion cells in it, and we put that new pancreas in you and you don't have diabetes anymore.
That's the future that scientists are building inside the old Amaskeg Mills in Manchester.
Behind me is a clean room that is manufacturing, in that room, beta cells.
With the help of an $80 million Department of Defense grant, Kamen created the Advanced Regenerative Manufacturing Institute, or ARMI, in 2017. Since then, it's grown into a 200-member organization with a mission to advance the bioeconomy of our nation through manufacturing cells, tissue, and bone.
ARMI is about to create the alternative to almost every condition you can imagine where there's a chronic treatment. We are trying to create a cure.
One of the goals is to turn the mill yard into a manufacturing facility that can grow replacement human organs at commercial scale. It's called regenerative medicine.
We're going to build the basis of this new industry. And we will turn this whole area into Regen Valley. Let California have Silicon Valley, we'll have Regen Valley.
Scientists at ARMI are working toward using a patient's own cells to grow a new organ that their body recognizes as its own. For the 100,000 people waiting for a life-saving organ transplant, this would reduce the risk of rejection and prolong the life of the transplanted organ.
Not since the invention of antibiotics or vaccines has there been as big an opportunity in the world of medicine.
I want to just see him and hug him is what I want to do and say thank you for everybody because I could cry.
And so she did.
Hello.
Hello, Mom. How are you?
Good. So happy to meet you.
And we were there for the moment my mom got to hug the man who has made her difficult journey a little easier.
I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for people, you know, my doctors, my family, friends, people like you who are always trying to find a better way to survive, to live.
And while my mom lives with the reality that a fourth transplant is likely inevitable, their conversation fueled the flames of hope.
If we can start manufacturing organs using cells from the intended recipient instead of whoever the random donor was, when we give that new organ to somebody, it's like we replaced your failed organ with one manufactured by the original equipment manufacturer. You're a mom and dad. It's got your genes.
It's incredible.
Kamen admits we are years away from using lab-grown organs for transplantation, but in the meantime,
we're hoping that this will be something that changes the world.
DECA's in-home overnight hemodialysis unit is now awaiting FDA approval.
10 years ago, we started very quietly working on that, and I can tell you that now, around 2 years ago, a little more than 2 years ago, we had so many of these machines built that we started a clinical trial with more than 50 patients, and we've now done in excess of 7,000 complete therapy sessions. Not a single one ended up with what's called an adverse event.
Kamen says the self-administered therapy allows patients to safely and effectively get dialysis while they sleep, a stark alternative to the average 15 hours a week the patients might spend in a clinic.
So I would go every other day. I would sit there 4 to 5 hours back in the 80s, right? I hated every minute of it.
Dartmouth Health nephrologist Charles Hopley says right now, hemodialysis can only safely be done while someone is awake and paying close attention to the machine.
If there was a modality to kill two birds with one stone, so to speak, and do that therapy at nighttime, and it was a safe thing, and the patient was comfortable with it, and the environment was sound, then I think it'd be tremendous.
Kamen considers the machine a strong bridge between the present and the future of regenerative medicine. If all goes according to plan, Kamen says certain lab-grown organs will be ready for transplantation by the end of this decade.
For me, it's like that full circle of life, and it's very hopeful and kind of gives you chills.
When we see people that benefit from what we do, it's what energizes us to keep going.
And the 72-year-old isn't stopping anytime soon. Kamen's team has projects underway on everything from preventing macular degeneration to scaling solutions for people with diabetes and more.
Everything that Army's doing, you're doing, is all hope for the future, not for me, but for the millions of other people all over the world.